Hello students, today we will learn the chapter 3rd, Law of Motion. In this chapter, first we will learn what are force. A force is that physical cause that change or tend to change the shape or motion of the body. It means it is not necessary that every force will change the shape or motion of a body. Okay? There are two type of forces. First, balance forces, and second one is unbalanced forces. Let's see the definition of balance forces. If the resultant or net of all the forces acting on a body is equal to zero, then this is called balance forces. And let's see the unbalanced forces. If the resultant or net of all the forces acting on a body is not equal to zero, then this is called unbalanced forces. Let's see the example of forces. There is a body kept on a surface. There is no force acting on it. In second condition, there are two forces acting on the body. The magnitude of both forces are same. So, the body is in rest condition or it is not in motion. So, it is the example of balance forces. In third condition, there are also two forces work on it. But the magnitude of first force, that is F1, is greater than the magnitude of second force, that is F2. So, the magnitude of first force is greater, so the body will move towards the higher magnitude force, that is F1. Now let's see what is inertia. The mass of an object is the measure of its inertia. We can also see its second definition. The natural tendency of object to resist a change in their state of rest or uniform motion is called inertia. Students, let's see what are the Newton's laws of motion. There are three laws of motion of Newton. The first law of motion is a body continues to be in a state of rest or of uniform motion in a straight line unless an external force doesn't work on it. The external force applied on it. Let's see example. Here is a football kept on the ground. It will remain in a static position until a boy doesn't kick on it. Okay. Let's see the next law, second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to force applied on it. F directly proportional to delta P divided by delta T. Here P is momentum, T is time. We know the formula P equal to mv, momentum equal to mass multiplied by velocity. F, we will put this value here. F directly proportional to P, we will put mv in place of v in place of p divided by delta t. Since mass of the object is constant, so it will come out of delta. Now F directly proportional to m delta v upon delta t. We know acceleration is equal to rate of change of velocity, so we will put a, where a is acceleration. F equal to k m multiplied by a. Here k is constant. If the value of k is equal to 1, then the formula F equal to m a with m a will derive. It is the second law of motion. Let's see what are the third law of Newton. According to third law, to every action there is always an equivalent opposite reaction, that is F12 is equal to F21. Let's say its example. Here is a boy that is coming from a boat to ground. His one leg is on boat and second leg is on ground. Now he will push by this leg to boat and go to the ground. For this he will act on the boat and go to the ground. For this action will be done on boat and reaction is on the ground. What will happen here? The boat will go to the away from the ground and the boy will go to the ground. This is the third law of Newton's.